This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. QuinStreet, Inc. is a publicly traded marketing company based in Foster City, California. QuinStreet uses performance-based advertising with search engine marketing strategies to promote clients over the internet. QuinStreet was founded in 1999, and has launched or acquired dozens of websites and other media properties. The company was investigated in 2012 by 20 U.S. states for using deceptive marketing tactics to promote for-profit schools to U.S. veterans. QuinStreet, which was not found guilty, was fined $25 million and made several changes to its practices. Contents 1. History 2. Deceptive advertising investigation and settlement 3. References 4. External links. History. QuinStreet was formed in 1999 by Doug Valenti, Chairman and CEO Bronwyn Syiek, another founding team member, is President and COO. The company was first profitable in 2002 with revenues of $13 million. By April 2009, QuinStreet reported $300 million in annual revenue and approximately 450 employees. In February 2015, Nielsen NetRatings named QuinStreet the 8th top advertiser, after Education Dynamics, USA publications. In February 2012, the company acquired the media assets of Ziff Davis Enterprise, which included Ewecom, ChoInsightcom, BaselineCom, ChannelInsiderCom, and WebBuyersGuideCom, and others for its second quarter of fiscal 2013. The company reported total revenue of $718 million. Adjusted EBITDA was $112 million, or 16% of revenue for its fiscal 2016. QuinStreet reported total revenue of $2,977 million. Deceptive advertising investigation and settlement. In June 2012, the company was under investigation by the Attorneys General's offices of 15 separate U.S. states, led by the Attorney General of Kentucky, Jack Conway. The company was accused of targeting military veterans with deceptive recruiting practices for its for-profit school clients. QuinStreet denied wrongdoing and no determination of guilt was made. The company cooperated with the Attorneys General and entered into a voluntary agreement to update its websites to ensure clarity around schools' advertising. In addition, the company agreed to pay $25 million to the states involved as part of a consumer protection settlement with what had expanded to 20 state attorneys general, and turn over the website Gabilcom to the United States Department of Veterans Affairs to settle the civil investigation. References. Carrot Garon, Tomio, the 18th of August 2009. QuinStreet publicly boasts about its earnings. WSJ blogs. Wall Street Journal, retrieved the 5th of January 2011. Students and new graduates. The Telegraph, the 19th of June 2012. Predatory practices. Attorney General of Kentucky, the 27th of June 2012.